Welcome to the Pre-Kinder Year-End Program. To properly start our program, let us pause in silence for the opening prayer to be followed by the singing of the Philippine National Anthem.
Lord, if we could, we would feel our hands and the wonderful things you give us. Then we lift them up and give them back to you. In the name of the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit.
Sang awit ng Pilipinas.
Hayang mag-ibig, Diyos ng sinahanan, alam ng puso, sa titik mo'y buhay. Upang hinirang, tuyang ka ng magiting, sa mandudupin, di ka pasisigil, sa nagatang tutok, sa simoy at sa langit mong pagaw.
This time, we listen to Angela Thiel S. De La Cruz as she delivers her opening message on behalf of the pre-kinder learners.
Today is the last day of our class. As we end, we want to say thank you to all of you who make each day of our school life fun and exciting. Pre-kinder has given us a lot of wonderful experiences, like sharing stories and jokes with our classmates, doing exciting art activities, participating in fun games and learning our day-to-day lesson. We will treasure all these learnings and memories with us as we move to the next level. To our dear parents, we want to say thank you for being our seatmate and coach. To UST Angelicum College, thank you for giving us the chance to enjoy learning. As our way in giving thanks to all of you we offer to this program, we hope that you would like it. I am Angela De La Cruz, pre-kinder learner.
Isaiah 45:12. God said, I am the one who made the earth and created the peoples who live on it. My hands, I stretched out the heavens. Thus, like our hands, God used his hand to make the earth, the sky, and even us.
God's creation. In the beginning, there was no earth or sky, sea or animals. So God created the earth, but it was too dark. God wanted the earth to look beautiful and bright, so he created day and night. He created the sun to give light during the day and moon to shine during the night.
And it's a true light. Sometimes it's really bright. Without the sun, it would be dark. No day, only night. The sun has energy. He warms the air. He warms the sea. He warms the land. Even sand. Then thank the sun for the energy he gives you and me. Wow.
The new moon. Pretty moon, little new moon, I look up to you. I must make a wish, for surely will come true. Pretty moon, little new moon, my wish to you. Please do not tell, because I might break the spell. Pretty moon, little moon, please stay with me and be my light as I close my eyes and sleep tonight.
You love colorful leaves and long brown trunk. We know from the beautiful trees on that trunk. They give us water, they need soil, peace and light when we need it all. We're out from the dark, rock and grows a mighty strong tree.
Come back tomorrow instead. I will smiled. I have a little bunny whose ears are so fluffy. Besides, a brown as a special. He's going as wide as a snow. He likes to hop and hop. With his nose, the bunny cannot talk. But when he pitches his nose, I know he likes to carry. I can tell when he's happy. As when he pitches his nose and eats his carrot.
God looked at his creations and he was so happy. And he said, I will make my most beautiful creation. Will take care of the earth. And God made man his most beautiful creation.
Let us again welcome the youngest learners of USD Angelicum College, the pre-kinder learners and their role in the story. Dizon and Nathan Jacob C., the son. Digayu Nathan Gabriel, the moon. Gera Joseph Anaya M., the tree. Ong Liam Alexander E., the tree. Gera Giovanna Marishka M., the flower. Ladisla Liv Lilian P., the flower. De La Cruz Angela Thiel S., the butterfly. Banatao Maxine Venice R., the bird. Cruz Ashandra Aleya P., the bunny. Erlano Mia Emmanuel B., the storyteller. Thank you very much, pre-kinder learners, and welcome to YS1. Welcome to the YS1 Virtual Moving Up Ceremony. With this year's theme, We Rise Up, Shaping Our Future Together. Let us all first pause in silence for the opening prayer to be followed by the Philippine National Anthem. This time, we'll listen to Sebastian McCoy M. Santos and Santhi M. Ambuido as they deliver their opening message on behalf of the YS1 learners, Batch 2020-2021.
Since the pandemic, we started to do online learning for our safety and everyone around us. Online learning can be both fun and challenging. We were able to spend more time with our family and get them involved in our learning and some activities. Though at times I miss going to school, I miss my teachers and classmates. Learning is a challenge in the time of pandemic, but with great perseverance and guidance of our teacher and with the help of our parents, we were able to adjust to the new way of learning. Internet connection is a big factor too. It was hard, but we have tried our best to learn. We should always stay positive and continue to see the good in learning, whether it's online or not. Always remember that we should never stop learning because learning makes us grow. I'm Sebastian McCoy Santos, YS1 learner.
Online class is really tough and challenging. For a few months, everything is new to us. We can share toys, read books together, go to the playground, and even share snacks with our classmates. Now, we can only see and talk to our classmates and friends on screen for 1.5 hours if we have good internet connection. I had a hard time adapting to this new normal, but thank you to our dear parents in UST and Jericho College who helped us to adjust and motivate us to enjoy learning. All the exciting activities that the school had designed and prepared for us, the everyday exercise and dance mixes up and give us the energy for the whole session. Experiments, planting, baking, repair, ideas, hands-on activities, games, ritual, parties are some of my favorite. Now every morning, I'm excited to wake up. I pray to God that this pandemic will be over soon so we can see each other again in UST and Jericho College. I am Santi M. Buido from Voice One Learner. Thank you.
Children of yesterday's dream, we are the promise of the future we bring. Waving the banner of love to all, to every nation, the rich and the poor. We are a world of the restless and young, and we need a hand to guide us.
Each other, build each other.
listen to Mrs. Leila Cizaratan, one of the YS1 parents, as she delivers her message of gratitude.
My warmest virtual greetings to our dear teachers, fellow parents, and Moving Up students. To our dear movers, I want to share with you the ABC farewell. A. All good things must come to an end. B. Believe in yourself, we believe in you. C. Congratulations on a job well done. You are finished the entire year of online class. You are very good not just in math, language, reading, pati na rin sa Filipino. Mommy and Daddy, Mama and Papa are so happy and proud of you. As you move up to YS2, you will meet new faces, new classes, and it will be scary at first. But it's okay. Those new faces will be your friends, that new classes will feel like second home, and all the new things you will learn will help you to become everything you want to be. Mommy and Daddy are very excited to see all the wonderful things that you will do in your life. You will change your mind many times, but it's okay. Always remember to follow your heart and do what truly makes you happy. Don't forget to be kind and be confident. Mommy and Daddy, Mama and Papa are your number one fans and your proudest cheerleaders. We will always be with you every step of the way to guide you, to support you, and to love you unconditionally. Again, congratulations to our not-so-little graduates.
Thank you for teaching me how to love, showing me what the word means, what I've been dreaming of. And now I know there is nothing that I could not do. Thanks to you for teaching me how to feel, showing me my emotions, letting me know what's real from what is not. What I've got is more than I'd ever hoped for. And a lot of what I've hoped for is thanks to you. No mountain, no valley, no time, no space, no heartache, no heartbreak, no far from grace.
We now listen to Louis Ann Arnel L. Salazar and Siler Yuwo C. Sandoval as they give their inspiring messages.
God has blessed us in so many ways, but the greatest of them all, given us our parents. Parents do everything just to give us the best in life. Having you by our side makes who we are today. You're not only parents to us, but a teacher and best friend. Day by day, we grew up cocooned with your love and comforted by your hugs and motivated by your lives. The sweet words wake us up every morning, makes us feel love. Thank you. This is a very short word to convey our gratitude and how blessed we are to be raised by you. To God Almighty, thank you for giving us our parents. I am Lynn Arnold Salazar, Wise One Learner.
Hello, teacher, classmates, and parents. Today is a great day for us. As we celebrate Moving Up Day, we also step forward in achieving our dreams. This day is also a chance to give credit to the person behind this wonderful moment, our parents. To our dear parents, thank you. Thank you because not only us in the screen who study hard, but you as well. You give the most effort in every possible way. From choosing your student home as our school, providing gadgets with good Wi-Fi connection, buying school supplies, getting modules and materials, up to the foods that we show to our classmates during snacks and arts. It is you who should get the same achievement. Above all this, most important is the time and patience that shows your love for us. We want you to know that we are happy and blessed to feel that every day. You truly deserve this celebration. Today, we serve as your motivation. But tomorrow is the start of big school that we will learn and make you our greatest inspiration. To our dear parents, we love you very much. Thank you and congratulations. I am Siler Yuwel, C. Sandoval, Wise One Learner.
I am down and all my soul so weary. When troubles come and my heart's burnt empty.
When I am still and wait here in a silence until you come and sit a while with me.
You raise me up so I can stand on mountains.
raised me up.
You raised me
to
up.
Moving. I can be.
We now listen to another YS1 parent as she delivers her message of gratitude. Let us welcome Mrs. Marian G. Domingo.
To the UST Angelicum College administrators, to the faculty and staff of the Basic Education Program, to our very dear YS1 kindergarten teacher, Mrs. Mary Jane De Vera, to the very supportive and loving parents, and of course, to our sweet children, a warm afternoon. It is an honor to talk on this momentous event to represent the parents of the YS1 pupils. I cannot believe that it has been a year already. It seems like only yesterday when we were scouting for a school for our preschooler. When the pandemic came, most of us parents were anxious to send our children to a face-to-face classroom setting with the fear of the COVID-19 virus. Our first instinct as parents is the protection of our children. Some parents may even resort to homeschooling even before the government's decision to postpone the school year. In my case, I still want my child to grow in a regular school setting, but the disruption brought by the pandemic in our education system pointed us to modular and online classes as the best solution. It is at this point when my husband and I unanimously chose UST Angelicum College. Personally, it has been in my top list for my child's education because of my Tomasian background. Moreover, the shift to modular and online mode of teaching in response to the pandemic is already being practiced and mastered here in our school. Today, as we look at the past year with all the online activities for our YS1 child, we are glad that we made the right decision. Our son, John Paul, was a reluctant learner, especially in a new school using an online setting. Every morning has been a struggle to make him sit for 1.5 hours in front of the computer and make the most out of the lessons and activities being facilitated by teacher Jim. Although he is already advanced in reading English and Filipino words, he still has a lot to learn. I am personally very grateful to Teacher Jane for her patience, dedication, and unconditional love for our kids. She is always very willing to adjust to the needs of her learners without compromising the learning outcome. We have seen valuable improvement in our son's participation in the online classes. From a webcam shy child at the start of the school year to an active pupil who would dance and sing in front of the webcam so that Teacher Jane can see him participating. Our child finds all the routine activities interesting and meaningful, as shown by him telling us about them after each session. Even in a virtual class, our kids experience cool activities like games, action songs, storytelling sessions, dancing, cooking, planting seeds, and Halloween costume parties. They even sing Lupang Hinirang on Mondays, and they do physical exercises, crafts, and artworks on Fridays. There were times when my son boasted that they won over the girls in a calamansi relay game, or he's the winner in a bato-bato pick game. isn't like our kids who are in a regular school setup, but in fact, they're still in the safety of our homes. Having said all of this, as a parent, I can add that the most precious aid that Teacher Jane's class has given to our kids is the routine praying and that of being a prayer leader. The consciousness that someone has to lead the prayer is instilled in them. It's very helpful, especially nowadays when prayer is our weapon against this pandemic. Whenever we say grace before meals or recite a short prayer as a family, we can always ask our kids to lead the prayer and would use the prayer that they learned in their class. I wish to convey my gratitude to the whole basic education program for creating an excellent curriculum for our kids, even in this very hard time. I feel my child's education is not hampered by the lack of physical classroom meetings. Basic values are still inculcated in their lessons, like respect, obedience, discipline, love of family, love of God, the importance of taking care of the environment, and becoming a better person every day. The activities and learnings are limitless, even if the technology and resources or the internet are limited. Teacher Jane was very committed and hardworking, but I'm sure she's not working alone to achieve this. Hence, to the faculty and staff of UST Angelico, a big thank you for all of us, parents of Pius One. To my fellow parents, daddies and mommies, papa and mama, tatay and nanay, congratulations to us. They say that a kindergarten graduation is just a beginning. For us, after having gone through daily battles of this past year with the COVID-19 pandemic, our kids' moving up day is already a triumph and a chance to breathe fresh air, especially in the morning. It was not easy to multitask at home. With that question, we accepted the role of being shadow teachers, breadwinners, and housekeepers all at the same time. Some of us may even be frontline heroes in this fight against COVID-19. With your immeasurable love and selfless love, sacrifices, and support to our children's future, we all deserve a good pat on our back and several butterfly kisses from our kids. But then again, seeing our kids grow the best way we could hope for would be more than enough prize for us. Am I right? For our moving up princes and princesses, good job. You did well through listening and obeying Teacher Jane and your moms and dads as well. You prove yourselves brilliantly, even in this pandemic, by being resilient, independent, smart, motivated, and responsible in your words and deeds. Your infinite energy and thirst to know and explore further made you accomplish your goal in kindergarten. Your cute smiles, shy grins, or even silly laughter can intensely infect everybody in the family to see more the positive and beautiful side of life. As your parents, we only hope and pray that you will become happy, but righteous and God-fearing individuals ready to face life's challenges someday. Accept our heartfelt wishes for the best gift you have given us today, your moving up. You made us all so proud and you deserve a big hug from the entire family. 6 years from now, we hope to finally escort you on stage in our graduation march, on our real graduation ceremony, that you, our child, deserve. Again, thank you to the UST Angelicum College for taking care of our kids. You'll always be your loyal partners in this educational endeavor for our children. May the good Lord keep all our families and communities safe and healthy. Once again, congratulations, YS1 Class of 2020.
There's a place in your heart, and I know that it is love. And this place is much brighter than tomorrow. And if you really try, you'll find there's no need to cry. In this place, you feel there's no hurt or sorrow. There are ways to get there if you care enough for the living. Make a little space, make a better place. Heal the world, make it a better place for you and for me and the entire human race. There are people dying. If you care enough for the living, make a better place for you and for me. A love that cannot lie. Love is strong. It only cares for joy, forgiving. If we try, we shall see. In this bliss we cannot feel. There are dreams to stop existing and start living. Then it feels that always love's enough, always growing. People dying. If you care enough.
Different learning opportunities are offered to our preschool learners in order to meet their individual developmental needs. The academic progress and skills are valued to help in the formation of each learner as they continue to progress. Let us once again welcome the YS1 learners. Bangilan Jaffe Roche M. Benitez Matthew M. Domingo John Paul G. Makasling Sebastian Gray G. Milanes Jose Alfonso D. Narito McLean Aldrich M. Ponce de Leon Gab Angelo G. Sandoval Siler Ewell C. Santiago Sebastian M. Santos Sebastian McCoy M. Tantoco Marcus Frost A. Virayo Gabriel Levi M. Zaratan Lorenzo Jacob C. Acacio Eva Caterina A. Beltrano Bettina Angela G. Ambuido Santi M. Hetes Georgina Bernadette E. Makalalad Roshem Claudie S. Puente Jamie Alea P. Raqueño Yalhaila Sharpie. Ritual Isabel A. Salazar Louis Ann Arnell L. Sayo Ma Angela L. Turno Alexa Sarlene D. We now listen to Mrs. Catherine C. Dizon, the officer in charge of the lower level department of UST Angelicum College, as she delivers the closing message.
Good afternoon, dear learners. Moving Up ceremonies highlight your important achievements as you tread towards a more challenging journey ahead of them. It is an event worth sharing and celebrating with your parents, family members, teachers, friends, and school administrators who have been part of your success. Most of all, this is the moment to recognize all your efforts and hard work as you acquire the knowledge, skills, and competencies, and to develop further your attitudes and values for you to overcome the challenges of these times. and to look forward to a brighter future. On this occasion of your first Moving Up ceremony, let us also give thanks to your teacher, Ms. Jane De Vera, for her patience in nurturing to prepare all of you to the next level of your educational journey. Let us also extend our gratitude to your parents. Please give your parents a big hug for being with you as you tackled school works under the guidance of your teachers. Thank them for all the sacrifices they have done and congratulate them as well for successfully overcoming the many challenges you faced together. Share and celebrate your victory with them. Dear learners, never forget to keep learning, to keep having fun, and to always smile. It has been our pleasure and privilege to see your personalities grow day by day and see how you have developed in your learning. We care enough and think of each one of you as special and important. As you move to IS2, continue to rise up, be bold, be courageous, and be the best that you can be. Dream big and chase for your dreams. Congratulations, YS1 learners. Your UST Angelicum family is so proud of you. Keep safe and God bless. See you in YS2.
Let us now join in the singing of the UST hymn.
Good day and thank you very much to everyone.